Hello and welcome to this look at the HUD and the Compare tool within Boris Continuum with me, Ben Brownlee from Boris Effects. Now, both of these tools are going to be used in interesting ways to speed up our effects creation and to make sure that we're not pushing any effects too far. So let's pop over to the other side and see what we can do with the HUD and with the Compare tool. Let's look now at how we can use the Compare tool in Adobe. We're going to be looking at this in Premiere Pro, but everything we see here also works in After Effects. So Compare is a great tool in Boris Continuum, whether you want to know whether you've pushed an effect too far, or whether you just want to see how an effect is going to look against another clip. If we take a look at our first shot here, we can see that this clip is a little bit soft. So I'm going to use one of my favorite utility filters, which is BCC Magic Sharp. And this has saved me more than a few times with footage that is slightly soft. And I'm going to come up to my presets, and I'm going to use the one that I use almost all the time, which is the high threshold sharp edges. So now all we have to do is dial in how much sharpness we want with sharpen amount. But how much is too much? I'm going to come into compare, and I'm going to choose what type of compare I want. I can do a compare side by side, so we can look at the before and after over here. Or we can compare against itself, and if I turn on the HUD, we get a nice wipe line. We can just look at the before and after on the clip itself. In this case, I'm going to choose compare side by side and just slide over a little bit so we've got the face in focus. We can also change the right offset, which is useful if we are zoomed in a little bit. Let's zoom in to 150% and move our viewer over. I can change my right offset so we can see both of these in the same viewer there. There we go. So now all I have to do is dial in the amount of sharpness I want, and I can always compare it with the original, because it's very easy to be tempted just to keep pushing it really, really far and giving us a sort of over sharpened look. So when I'm happy, around about 25, we can see that we've got an appreciable amount of sharpness compared to the original. We take a look at the glasses here and the beard as well as a lot more defined. When I'm happy with that, I'll just turn this off, fit us back to the viewer, and I can look at the full clip, and I'm happy with how that is. If we take a look at our second shot, which is our hand outstretched, what I want to do is to match this to the shot previous to it. So I've just moved another version of that shot underneath this clip. We could even move the clip itself a little bit further over, but I want to be able to compare to a different layer. So we're going to use another effect now, and I'm going to come back to my old favorite, the BCC Fast Film Process. And we'll come into our effects browser and we'll find something that looks that same sort of cool blue as we had the previous shot. I'm going to use blue wash, I think, and just hit that one there. And now I can see whether that's going to match up by using my compare tool. So instead of doing side by side, which is what we did before, or compare to look at the layer itself, we can also compare with below, which lets us look at the clip below it. Or if we have multiple layers, we can compare with a layer and then choose which of these layers we're going to look at. In this case, we've only got two video tracks, so compare with below is going to work out just fine for us. And it's at this point where I can still come in and wipe over here just to see a better transition over on this one, and I'll come into my post-process and try and match these shots up a little bit better. And we'll wipe this over to C, and I'm pretty happy with where that is, so I'll turn my compare off, and we'll play that back and see how that looks. And I think that's cutting together quite nicely, and that's just how easy it is to use the compare tool in Adobe Premiere Pro. Let's look now at the different features that the HUD plays within Premiere Pro. This works in exactly the same way in Adobe After Effects. So we can use the HUD to do a number of different things depending on what type of filter we're using. If I come over to my first shot over here, and on my blue screen intro, I am going to actually find a bit more of a flattering frame, which is fairly tricky to do. And I am going to use Bcc Primatte Studio. Now, as soon as I have the effect selected and the HUD turned on, I have this heads-up display available to me in the viewer. And if I zoom in on the viewer even further, we can still see we have this display available here. Now with Primatte Studio, what this allows us to do is to make the basic key without even touching any of our controls over in the effect controls window. I can come up, I can click on auto analyze, and Primatte Studio will go along and try and find the best color to begin to key out. I can look at my matte status and see that actually we still need to do a bit of cleanup on this. So with my clean background already selected, all I have to do is just draw on the viewer and that will clean up my matte for me. I can even have a look at the final matte and maybe zoom out just a little bit and I can see any other areas that I might be missing. If I needed to add anything back in, I can just go clean foreground and add in a bit more of those colors back in one more time. I can even do spill suppression using the same controls. If I turn on final composite again, then I have my composite available to me immediately. If I wanted to do anything else such as secondary spill removal or matte refinement, then we still have those controls over on the effect controls window, but most of the initial key can be done directly within the HUD. If we take another effect, for example, the BCC directional blur, this looks a little bit different when I apply this and have it selected. So now we only have two controls. We have a blur amount and we have an angle. If I change my apply mode to screen, I still have complete control over everything within the HUD here, simply by moving the controls in the viewer. And if I add a colorized glow instead, have that selected, you can see I now have the same sort of controls, but we have a few more of them to control things like blur amount, softness, and hue. So the HUD lets us make changes to the basic controls on all of our effects, and different effects have different controls available to us. If you don't want to see the HUD, at any point you can just turn off the HUD button in the effect and it will just disappear, leaving you with just your effect. And of course, if we go to render this out, the HUD doesn't render as part of the effect. And that's how easy it is to use the HUD controls with the Adobe version of Boris Continuum. If you found this video useful, then remember to hit the like button. For more ways to master Boris Continuum in Adobe, subscribe to the Boris Effects YouTube channel and check out our other tutorials. If there's something missing, then let me know in the comments below. My name is Ben Brownlee from Boris Effects. Thanks for now.